गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे See, there is a Shanti mantra. I'll just chant it and then I'll tell you the meaning. Om Bhadram Karne Vishnuyama Devaha Bhadram Pashye Makshabhirya Jatraha Sthirai Rangai Istushtuvagam Sastanubihi व्यशेम देवहितंयदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. Whenever a seeker begins on the spiritual journey of self-realization, God-realization, then it has to be a positive approach. It cannot be a negative approach. And that positive approach, where does the, can the world be positive? See, is the in a glass which is filled with milk, half glass filled with milk, do you call it half full or half empty? That glass is not deciding, that you are deciding. And that how you approach it, how you talk about it, will depend upon your mental setup. See? And therefore, when it says Om Bhadram Karne Bhishunuyama Devaha, may we discover positive meaning by whatever we hear by our ears. This is basic minimum, that let us not by our choice. Bhagwan has given us choice. So let us not by choice expose our ears to something inauspicious. What is inauspicious? Too much news is inauspicious. Too many serials is inauspicious. Too much listening to gossip is inauspicious. Someone trying to break your faith is inauspicious. Someone trying to undermine your ability, your capacity, your faith, your knowledge, your convictions about something, about God, about your religion, about your self-confidence, about your self-esteem, that is not worthy of listening. No, I am just telling you what I am observing. Observe and give, throw it out. If it is good, if it is something constructive, then take it on. Then Bhadram papashye maksha bhirya jatraha. May we Bhadram pashye maksha bhirya jatraha. Pashye maksha, pashye ma aksha. So may I see all good with my eyes. So world is the same, but is your, just like today's news, it only talks about the negativity in the world. So are we only going to talk negative about, see negative in the world? Or are we going to see what is good in this world? What are your eyes seeking out? Pashye and Jatraha, may we engage in all divine activities. This is a divine activity. It is going to help us. It is going to calm us. It is going to... this interaction will make us know ourselves a little bit more than what we knew ourselves before. Every satsang does that. But what happens? Many people do japa, do dhyan. They are pursuing the right in the right manner. But because your senses are the windows to the world, but these senses are not under control. And they are, ye kon hai, wo kon hai, aise kyun hai, waise kyun hai, why, what is this, what is that, what did you say, your name was not taken, why you have to interfere in anyone's conversation? And the senses are dependent on the intellect. Senses are dependent on the mind. Mind is dependent on the intellect. So in some places it is also said there are not five senses but six senses. The five senses here and the mind is the sixth one. So they have to be reined in. Who is reining those senses in? Are we making the correct choices where to expose them? That will depend upon our conviction. Conviction is the seat of intellect. When Arjuna was so confused, he handed over the reins. Who was the best charioteer that he could find in the world at that time? The Lord himself. So he handed over his chariot to the Lord. The Lord has the capacity to hold the reins and take it in the correct direction wherein the Arjuna could function and do what he was required to do. But our senses, ears are hearing something. Someone says something, we get disturbed. Someone says something, we get distracted. Someone says something, we doubt another person. It should not be like this. And therefore, भद्रं पश्ये माक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैः स्तुष्टुवाग्सस्तनूभिः स्थिरैरङ्गैः व्यशेमदेवहितं यदायुः. सो मे वी लीड अवर ऑर्डेन्ड लाइफ for our welfare as well as the welfare of all by health and spirit or with our limbs. So our disposition in the daily world should be such that we only see goodness, we only share goodness, we only share positivity, see positivity, we hear positivity, not out of fear. It's not out of fear. Then why? Because it is the right thing to do. The basic tenet is that if we want to be on the spiritual journey, then our senses and the mind must be in control. The pratyahar must come about. Pratyahar is where the mind is not leaking out of the senses. And such a controlled mind, such a disciplined mind and senses alone are beneficial for a student, for a devotee, for a seeker to move ahead on his journey. And therefore, we cannot stop functioning in this world. Nobody is asking you to stop functioning in this world. Then what do? you function in this world for the welfare of the world. Welfare of the world, people, society, community, country. Happy Independence Day today. Bolo Bharat Mata ki Jai. Today is India's Independence Day. So may we lead our life for our welfare as well as for the welfare of all. So automatically here non-violence comes, non-stealing comes, non-accumulation comes, controlling your senses comes. You know, in the yoga, the yama niyama, I keep saying it hundreds of times. Yama is living such a lifestyle wherein we do not disturb the world, nor do we get disturbed by the world. And how do you disturb the world? By your thoughts, by your work, by your mind, by your thoughts, that is the mind, by your speech and by your actions. And if we are not disturbing, it will lead to this point that we are not disturbed by other people's mind or thoughts, words and deeds. Towards this particular verse is taking us. Swastina Indro Vriddhashravaha Swastinav Pusha Vishwavedaha. Until and unless our limbs, hands, legs, our brain also, until and unless we don't engage them in activity, they do not become strong. So if at all you want to do activity, you don't go and be a hooligan on the streets and hit people and kill people, no. Then what do? You increase keep your body active by helping the society, helping the world. Why? How? Reading. Our Jennifer spends every morning so much time taking care of her beautiful garden. That is the exercise is required. If exercise is not there, the body will stiffen up. And for sadhana, if you want to sit in meditation or do your japa, if you are getting into long periods, then your body is able to sit for that long. Otherwise, after 5 minutes, it will start disturbing you. So therefore, that is the type of activity. But not only that, may the glorious Indra bless us. Who is Indra? Indra is the Lord of the mind. He is the Lord of the heaven. Heaven is only in our mind. Hell is also only in our mind. So we don't want to go the hell way. We want to go the heaven way. So may the Lord of the mind, the Lord of the heavens, bless us with good thoughts. And he, Indra, he is also the Lord of the hands. So he expresses through hands. And if you see the word Indra, it also, we have these five senses. They are also called Indriyas. Indriyas means senses. So Indra, the mind alone, is expressing as the five senses. And that Indra alone is expressing through the hands to grab whatever the five senses are, seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting. So this is how he keeps feeding himself. Who? The mind. Controlling of this mind. Mind is available, but it is not leaking through the senses. Hands are there, but they are not workaholic. They are still. Otherwise, pair hilte rehte na logon ke. The leg keeps shaking like this. So that is not required. So may the glorious Indra bless us, and wise Pusha bless us, and may the Lord Sun bless us. May the Swasti Nastarksho Arishtanemi Swasti No Bruhaspatir Dadhatu. May the destroyer of obstacles, Tarksha is the Garuda. Garuda is the huge eagle with that 15 meter span. he is said to be the vehicle of Lord Narayana. But more so, Garuda is the eagles. What do? They kill snakes. Snakes are poisonous. They eat rats. Rats are desire. That's why Ganesha is sitting on a rat. That is his vehicle. He's on top of the desires. So when we think of Tarksha, when we think of Garuda, we are invoking Garuda. Garuda is another just invocation of Garuda, just like we invoked Indra. We are invoking Garuda that he may remove all the shortcomings within us. Because when the Garuda flies, it has two wings, it is flying. From the winds, from the sound of the flapping of the wings, the Veda Dhvani, the sound of the Vedas comes out. And what are those two wings? They are your bhakti and jnana, your yin and yang, your left brain and right brain. So when bhakti and jnana both are there, when you are devoted to the higher, when you are pursuing the higher, that will not allow, when discrimination is taking place with dedication, then the sins that come by way of unwanted negative interaction with the world through our senses, by our mind, through the senses into the world, that is kept at bay. May the Tarksha bless us, and Swasti no Brihaspatir Dadhatu. So also may Brihaspati bless us. Who is Brihaspati? Brihaspati is the guru of all the gods, the guru of Indra. So may, and Brihaspati in us is our intellect. So may the intellect bless us. Because why do we need blessings of the intellect? Because it can go into gossiping, it can go into fault finding, it can go into lack of self-confidence, it can go into wrong convictions. There is enough, you must have also experienced many times. You may not have told anyone, but you see us in a particular situation, you find yourself and you have a connotation of that particular situation, and you are disturbed from inside. Afterwards you realize that your assessment of that situation was wrong, which was based on some previous data or corrupted data. So therefore, that intellect which is dedicated to the higher, to the self, to the God, that alone is beneficial, that alone is integrated, that alone is conducive for our spiritual growth. And thinking in this manner, the journey to the self, by the self, in the self, is immediate. These are the intellect, the mind, the senses, the world. These are all taking. We have found it. We are with these things. We are with these equipments. What do we do with this equipment? Is there a distance between the self that I am and the self that I want to be? No. Is there a distance between the wave and the water? No. Then why am I not able to catch that I am the infinite one? Why am I not able to be the infinite one? Because of our distracted mind. And our mind is getting distracted by way of senses, by way of mind, by way of wrong conclusions, that is convictions. So this prayer, I'll repeat it again, close your eyes, listen to the prayer and explanation I have given, and pray to the higher that may all our faculties, we are not only praying and going to put efforts to not become extrovert so that they get integrated towards the higher, but we are also inviting the gods, the sun god, the Garuda, the Brihaspati, the Guru Maharaj, and seek their blessings so that we reach the destination. Wherever there is a journey, that journey is always imagined. Wherever there is a journey, it is only imagined. It is imagined because we have imagined that we are limited. That's why we are not able to realize the self. And whenever there is a journey, you cannot traverse the journey. You can go walking, but you need legs. You can go by car, travel faster, but you need a car. So you need the blessing of the car. So in our, we even pray to the car. We pray to the animals. They are the vehicles, elephant or horse or whatever. So whatever is, as long as we feel we are an individual and we have these equipments, we need the various gods or various productive potentials who are functioning behind these faculties, who are empowering these faculties to help us, guide us, bless us, and not allow these faculties to go in the wrong direction. Om Bhadram Karne Bhishunhyama Devaha Bhadram Pashye Makshabhirya Jatraha Sthirai Rangai Istushtu Vagam Sastanubihi Vyashem Devahitayadayuhu Swastina Indro Vruddhashravaha Swastina Pusha Vishvavedaha Swastina Starkshyo Arishtanemihi Swastino Bruhaspatir Dadhatu Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Assess, sit in the meditation. In a general sense, assess, are your faculties divine oriented or are your faculties undivine, which is called the world, which is called multiplicity, which is called which leads to anger, greed, jealousy, envy, hypocrisy, arrogance. In which direction? And if you are not perfect, then invoke the blessings of the Lords, gods. Make this positive affirmation, Bhadram Karnevi, O Lord, O Divine, may my senses hear, see, smell, feel, taste only the auspicious, only that is helpful. May my limbs, the speech, hands, legs, with which we interact with the world, may they engage in activities, only in those activities which are beneficial, which are for the welfare of one and all. Towards the plants, flowers, trees, children, people, may the various gods being the productive potential, the power in the mind is the Lord Indra. Power in the intellect is the Brihaspati. Power in the eyes is the sun, the Lord Sun. Power in the ears is the Ashwini Kumar, or the directions. The power behind the nose is the Ashwini Kumar. So these are all different divine potentials which are not separate from you. We are calling them gods, but actually, just as the water in the wave and in the water in the ocean is one and the same, the gods are subtle, senses are gross, but senses cannot function. That one self alone, when it functions as the ability to see, that ability, that power to see is the Lord Sun. The quality of space is sound. So we invoke the gods of the space. What are the gods of the space? They are the directions. We invoke their blessings for our ears. And this way, seeking blessings from everyone, we must not be on an arrogant journey. We must collect blessings wherever it is possible. Must not be obsessive about it, but that is a general disposition. Feel the gratitude that all these faculties are still functioning, without too much drama, mind is healthy, senses are healthy, body is relatively healthy, now utilize it. Towards the higher.